Let's take a look at a word problem. This one states, you deposit $500 into an account that earns 8% quarterly. Find an equation that gives the amount of money in the account after T years, the amount in the account after 5 years, and when it will contain $1,000. Now, I have all the general information written down here. We have the initial amount, P, equals $1,000. That's how much you deposited. The interest rate is 8%. And it said it is, I'm into an account that has 8% quarterly. What that means is it is compounded 4 times a year, which is N here. This variable N represents the number of times it's compounded per year. In this case, it's 4. So we have an 8% interest rate with it compounded 4 times, and then T is the number of years that it's been, the money's been in the account. And here, this equation right here represents the amount of money after T years. So it is A of T is equal to the initial amount times the quantity of 1 plus the interest rate divided by the number of times it's compounded raised to that number times T. Now, when you plug everything in, we're going to get an equation in terms of T, and that's what this first question asks. We have to get an equation for the money after T years. So let's just plug everything in. We have A of T is equal to P is 500 times 1 plus 0.08, because 8%, when you move the decimal, is going to give you 0.08 divided by 4 raised to the 4t. Well, 0.08 divided by 4 is going to give you 0.02, and 1 plus 0.02 is going to give you 1.02. So this is equal to 500 times 1.02 raised to the 4t power. Now this is the equation for this example here. This is the general equation for the amount of money in the account after T years, right here. Once you plug in T for a certain number of years, it'll tell you how much money you will have in that account. So now what we want to do is find out how much money we have after 5 years, how much, what it's been in 5 years, We plug in 5 to see how much money we have in the account after 5 years. So when we do that, we have A of 5 is going to be equal to 500 times 1.02 to the 4 times 5. And that is equal to 500 times 1.02 raised to the 20th power. Now, when you do that multiplication, the answer is going to give you $742.94. So A of 5 turns out to be $742.97. So when you raise 1.02 to the 20th power and then multiply that by 500, you're going to get $742.97 as the amount of money in the account after 5 years. Now, the next part of the problem asks us to find how long it'll take us to get to $1,000 in the account. Now, the easiest way for us to do this is going to be able to graph it. What we will use is two equations, one of which is this equation here, and another is y equals 1,000. I'll do that on the next board. Now we've found the equation for this particular problem, where A of T equals the amount of money in the account after a certain number of years. And that equation turns out to be 500 times 1.02 raised to the 4t power. We also found how much money we'll have in our account after 5 years. But now we want to know how long will it take for us to have $1,000 in the account. Now, the easiest way to do that is simply graphing it. And what I have here, this graph, is the graph of this picture. Now, I graphed two lines and not just one. I graphed the A of T, where this what is normally the y-axis, the vertical axis here is the A of T axis, and this horizontal axis here is the T axis, or the time. So each one of these right here, this is 1 year, 2 year, 3 years, all the way up to 10 years. And then on this vertical axis, this is $200 in the account, $400 in the account, $600 in the account, $800 in the account, and $1,000 in the account. Now, the two lines I graphed were this first one here, the, our original equation, and A of T equals 1,000. Now, what we want is to know how long it will take for us to get $1,000 in the account. So if you set these two equations equal to each other, you'll get 1,000 is equal to 500 times 1.02 raised to the 4t. If you solve that equation for t algebraically, you would find the answer 4t. But the thing is, that proves to be rather difficult, and the easiest way to do it is simply by graphing. And so what you want to do is you want to see where the two graphs intersect. And this intersection point is the same as setting these two equations equally to each other and solving algebraically. So this point right here represents a number of years it'll take for this equation or this curve to meet $1,000. And so that's how long it'll take this account to reach $1,000. Now the thing is, I drew this using a calculator. You look at a calculator, see what it looks like, and I represented that here for you. The easiest way to do it is just plug both of these into your calculator, where A of T is Y and T is X. Same thing, it's just going to give you, it's just how your calculator expects the notation. But when you plug it in, you just want to solve and find where these two are equal to each other, and that turns out to be at X equals, well, in this case, t equals 8.75. So after 8.75 years, our account is going to have $1,000 in it. And that's represented by this graph, where these two graphs intersect. And that's how you solve trying to find how much money you have in an account when it's dealing with an exponential like this, because this here is an exponential function. And it just turns out to be a lot easier to graph it and solve visually. So we found the equation to be 500 times 1.02 times 4 to the t. We used that to find out how much money we'd have after 5 years in the account. And then we graphed it to see how long it would take for us to get $1,000 in an account. And in this case, it turned out to be 8.75 years.